Good evening. I am joined here today at the State Emergency Operations Center with Dr. Janae Khaldoun, our Chief Medical Officer, and Dr. Michael Rice, our State Superintendent of Public Instruction. We are here tonight because the number of presumptive positive cases for coronavirus in Michigan has increased. As of right now, there are 12 presumptive positive cases in Michigan. We had 2 yesterday. We are at 12 today. We expect more to come. We are taking these cases very seriously and will continue to take every step to mitigate spread of the virus and keep Michiganders safe. In an abundance of caution, I am ordering the closure of all K-12 school buildings in Michigan for 3 weeks, starting Monday, March 16th, until Sunday, April 5th.
Greetings, Farmington Public Schools family. It's me, Dr. Goodrum, your interim superintendent, with a very special spotlight. Today, our board president, Mrs. Terry Weems, has joined us as we reflect upon this last year and all the impacts it has had on our students, our staff, and our community as a whole. Just to jog your memory, last year on March 10th, 2020, our community voted and supported a bond for our schools. And later that evening, that same evening, we heard that there was a first COVID case in Michigan. Not 6 days later, March 16th, we closed all of our schools for in-classroom learning. We know that everyone has not always agreed with our decisions, but all of our decisions have always been made with the best interests of our students, our staff, and the families. Those have been the heart of every single one of our decisions. We are navigating through a global pandemic that has never happened before in our lifetime. So I'd like to open up and give our wonderful board president, Mrs. Terry Weems, the opportunity to introduce herself.
Sure. Thank you, Dr. Goodrum. I am Terry Weems, and I am this year's president of Farmington Public Schools Board of Education. I have been on the board for, I'm in my 6th year now. I've been on the board since 2015. I am a very proud member of the Farmington Public Schools community. I love our environment and love Farmington, Farmington Hills. I have 3 children in the district. One is a senior in high school, and then I have 2 in middle school. So I'm very proud to be here. Thank you.
So, Mrs. Weems, as we reflect on this past year, how do you think that this pandemic has affected our students?
So that's a good question, and I think that that's going to be different depending on the student. It's obviously impacted every student, but every student in different ways. So for some of our students are actually performing very well in this environment. Some of our students appreciate the flexibility. They appreciate the smaller environment. They are doing pretty well self-navigating and are really well at self-directed activities. Some of our students are struggling, frankly. Some of our students really, really miss their friends. They miss that interaction, especially early on in the pandemic where, I mean, you know, people sort of felt like they were on lockdown. The summer looked drastically different for people. I know that especially in March, I think at first people sort of thought a couple weeks off of school might be fun, and it quickly turned into something pretty different. I hear from a lot of our students. They write me, they write the Board of Education, and I'm really proud at the tone and the degree of advocacy that I see on behalf of themselves and their peers. And they tell me that screen time is a challenge. Having that much screen time is a challenge on their eyes. They appreciate that their teachers are working with them, but it's tough. It's hard. So we've listened to that. And as a board, we've tried to increase in-person learning opportunities for those who want it. And to the extent we can do that, you know, we will, but we're listening. I know it's been hard on students, but I appreciate resilience and they're pressing forward.
Absolutely. I think that our students have, I mean, we always have to look for the silver lining, right? We have to look for the silver lining. There's a lesson in everything. So when I think about our students, I feel like they've, again, you said the word resilient, but they've had to become a lot more flexible. They've had to become a lot more independent. And I think that all of these skills, you know, even in the unfortunate manner in which they had to gain these skills, I think that these skills will be helpful to them as they continue to navigate through their lives and go into the future. So
I think you're right, Dr. Goodrum. I'm sorry, I didn't mean to cut you off, but there's another point there. There's something to be said about, you know, reading, writing, and arithmetic and all of the traditional sort of course offerings that a school provides. And interestingly, I think compared to other school districts, our students are really doing well comparatively in this pandemic environment. So that's all great. But there are other skill sets, life skills, that, you know, we're learning as a result of this pandemic, how to respond to crisis, how to respond to change, how to pivot, how to help each other, how to recognize when someone needs help or needs to talk. Those are the types of skills that I think, you know, people are building through this environment, especially our students.
Yes, absolutely. And I'm so glad that we have a lot of what you expressed, like even the mental health and the learning some of those coping skills. Mm-hmm. It is a point of pride that we have so many social emotional learning staff within mm-hmm. our district who have been able to work with students on developing those skills and support them mm-hmm. as they have needed, and they've needed additional support. Mm-hmm. But let's move away from our students, and students are at the, again, we are here for students. That's the reason that we are here. But we have to have people that help the students, and that's our staff. So how do you think that this pandemic has affected our staff?
Well, I think it's certainly impacted our staff significantly. I'd say, you know, in March, when we had a statewide shutdown, I was pretty proud in the spring, how Farmington Public Schools sort of responded initially. I mean, no one had any idea how to educate people remotely. I think we were well suited and well set up, you know, based on our IT department. We went out and, you know, made sure that everybody had the technology that they needed to be able to, you know, continue on. I really appreciated how teachers, you know, stepped up and, you know, figured it out and found a way to get us through the end of last year. That was unprecedented, and I think that we were definitely best in class there. I've seen our teachers react and have to pivot to changes in circumstances every week. They've been extremely, you know, I can't say how proud I am of all of that. Throughout the system, from, you know, teachers to bus drivers to the nutrition folks who are making sure that our families still have food, our IT department that keeps us all connected and running, TV10, who, you know, helps us with, you know, sharing messages and helps us, you know, with our board meetings and getting that all done, even though we're remote, our maintenance department, who's, you know, keeping up with the more strenuous, you know, requirements in terms of cleanliness, our paraprofessionals who are helping out both students and teachers. And I think some of them may also be helping out at YCare. All of our staff members are doing just tireless work. The counselors, I cannot even imagine how that is helping our students, not just with schedule changes and that sort of thing, but the seniors and their, you know, scholarship applications and college applications, the administrators, our nurses, our central office staff. I mean, everyone has really had to be responsive, be proactive, and constantly react to change. And change is hard. And this year has really aged me. I'm sure it's a tireless process. And I know that, you know, we don't get an opportunity to stop and reflect and thank people enough, but you know, this has been hard. But I think it seems easier to outsiders than I know it actually is. And that's why I just wanted to, you know, stop for a second and say thank you to everyone in the system for all of the work involved in making sure we're putting kids first.
Absolutely. And when we talk about pivoting, and I'm not sure that people know this, but when we were out, you know, when we were just fully remote, like our bus drivers were in buildings helping prepare materials, or they were delivering food to some of our families who couldn't make it to food pickups, and delivering technology to people who couldn't come for pickups and things of that nature. So everybody pitched in, every single one of our staff members. You know, the business office was operating still, you know, all the bills got paid. Everyone just continued to either do their job or pivoted to a different job to support the district as we supported our students. So we have a phenomenal staff, staff that is willing to do any and everything to make sure that every single one of our students has the best opportunity at success. Now, would you agree?
I would agree. I was able to visit a couple of buildings over the last couple of months, and I saw it in action, from the office staff to the teachers, parapros, everyone just working towards making sure that, you know, students are learning, growing. I know that some days are many days for many of our staff have been elongated, right? So you're working from the time you get up, it's just different because you've got different schedules to respond to, and the correspondence has increased, right? So there's so much more to read and respond to, more phone calls, more connections with parents or students, and well into the evening, then responding to changes, and you know, it's been never ending, and I look forward to a time when we get to, you know, pause and rest and properly thank people for all the work that they've been doing.
Yes, I hope every single one of our staff members are actually able to enjoy spring break, because so many have been working through their breaks to make these things happen. Like when you think about the December to January and all the changes that needed to take place, a lot of people were spending so much of their personal time to get those things accomplished because of their commitment and their dedication to our district and our students. But the staff are just one piece of the puzzle. We are one support that the students have. Their primary support are their families. So how has this pandemic impacted our families and our community, do you think?
So again, in a lot of different ways, you've got folks who have the ability and opportunity to support their students by, you know, creating, you know, classroom environments at home, right? So they've set up workstations for their, you know, children to be able to, you know, have a nice workspace and stay attentive. So I appreciate families who are doing that for their kids. I know there's a ton of families who have, you know, parents and other support members supporting their students mentally, socially, emotionally, right? So parents have had to create opportunities to create those social interactions with other students and with friends and neighbors and so forth and so on. I've seen and heard about pods, you know, family pods going on. So I appreciate how in a lot of ways communities have been coming together to help people who may have different jobs and circumstances that don't allow them to easily respond to the constant changes that we've had to, you know, put in place. So I really appreciate what, you know, I've come to call a village, and, you know, a lot of folks and families in Farmington Public Schools have that village that help each other out. So I think families have been extremely supportive. We get a lot of correspondence from the community. And what I will say is that, you know, everyone has a difference of opinion as to, you know, what the right path or course of action is, but people are listening, they're engaged, they're being respectful, and, you know, they want to understand a bit more because they want to help. And so I appreciate all of the advice and all of the offers to help and serve on committees, and participate in surveys, participate in helping us, you know, identify a new superintendent. All of that stuff has been really helpful from the community. We've also had a lot of folks come in and donate, right? Community members, organizations, companies, and I appreciate that as well. As recently as what, a couple weeks ago, with Meyer. That's all been extremely helpful, and, you know, makes you just stop and smile sometimes when you hear about stories. I see Farmington Public Schools featured in news articles and on television, in the news, with great stories about some of our teachers and some of our families and how they're coping. And it makes me smile. It's a point of pride for me.
It's definitely a point of pride. We have come through this all together. Like, mm-hmm. we definitely have. And that's one thing about Farmington Public Schools, like the way that we collaborate, even with a lot of our community organizations, and the way that we are striving to increase our parent involvement, because as you said earlier, there are lots of differences in opinions, and we do, as you say, receive a great deal of correspondence, and lots of advice and lots of recommendations and things. Yes. Nature. And we appreciate that.
Yes.
Because honestly, you know, every perspective is appreciated. Like, every perspective adds something that we can think about and look into and can be part of all of these solutions that we're trying to create for our families and our students and our school district. So again, I'm always grateful to families for their advocacy. Even if it's something that I personally disagree with, I never disagree with the fact that a parent has the right to advocate. Mm-hmm. And should always be an advocate for their child. So, mm-hmm. So yes, every single one of our parents is appreciated. Every single one of the caregivers, every single, you know, we have a lot of community-based organizations where some of our students live in group homes, and they have staff, you know, who act in the role of guardian, and every single one of them is appreciated too. We're all working together to get through this. And again, it feels like we are seeing a light at the end of the tunnel. So let's just continue to hope that we continue going in this direction. Yeah, so we have a lot to be thankful for in this district. Before I close out, do you have any closing words?
No, other than just a huge thank you. A thank you to our students for continuing to, you know, work either in person or remotely. A thanks to our staff, who again work tirelessly, and a thank you to our parents and our community members for supporting our students, supporting our staff, and for supporting each other.
Thank you so much. This has truly, truly been an incredible year. I often talk about, in times of challenge, that how thankful I am for the opportunity to learn new skills and to grow. And this has definitely been a year that has caused all of us to grow in many ways, but we have, and we have done it together. We have gotten through this together as a community, because that's what Farmington Public Schools is about, community. And that's why our tagline, which we said, it's not contrived. It is actually what we believe. We are better together. And so we sincerely appreciate again, every single one of our students, every member of our staff, every one of our parents and caregivers and guardians, every single community agency that has stepped up to make sure that our community comes out of this better than before. And so again, in closing, we just thank you. We thank you for every single thing that you have done this year, as I will reluctantly use the word celebrate this 1 year in the pandemic. And I guess it is a celebration, because you know what? We're still here and we're working and we're still moving our students forward. So it is a celebration. It's a celebration of all that we have achieved in this very difficult time. So again, thank you for tuning in. Thank you so much, Mrs. Weems, for taking the time out of your very busy schedule. joining us today. And thank you to all of you. We appreciate you. Have a wonderful day.